Shepherd of song, Shepherd of a song,
Savior of a song, Lover of a song.
We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We are overcome.
Us to open our mouth and declare this prayer point like this. Say, every mark of destruction. Every mark of destruction programmed into my destiny and my foundation. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Every mark of destruction programmed into my
we pray.
Amen.
Yeah, so people don't understand that prayer point. When I was reading the story of Nebuchadnezzar, when I saw the great and mighty things, or the way God demonstrated his power, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I asked myself, one thing occurred to me. I said, upon what God did to King Nebuchadnezzar, did King Nebuchadnezzar repent? Is there any place that was recorded in the Bible that King Nebuchadnezzar repented and started serving God? He only eulogized the Almighty Creator. He only make us to know that He is the Lord, is the Lord of Lords, is the King of Kings. In other words, what God did to King Nebuchadnezzar was enough for King Nebuchadnezzar to turn away from his idol and said, from henceforth, I will continue to worship the God of Daniel. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I don't know if I'm communicating.
Positive.
Amen.
Amen.
When I take a look at Pharaoh, when I saw what God did in the land of Egypt, even killing Pharaoh, the firstborn in the land of Egypt, all the firstborn in the land of Egypt, the Pharaoh only said one word: "We have sinned against God. They are not good people." I'm paraphrasing. That they are wicked, that they have really done evil, that Moses should go. He will allow them to go now. Benjamin, what am I trying to say? Did Pharaoh repent and said, henceforth, I have seen Almighty God who is greater than the gods of Egypt. Let me serve this God now. No. Pharaoh only repented and let the children of Israel go. Brethren, we are going to take that prayer point again. Every mark of destruction programmed into my life, programmed into the life of my children, programmed into my marriage, programmed into my foundation, They have not manifested now, but will manifest in the future to destroy all my efforts, all my waking up day and night for me not to make heaven. Command that mark of destruction to die. I was also reading the Bible again. There was a man, the Bible, Apostle Paul talked about Demas. Demas started with Paul. We were evangelizing, preaching together, doing the work of God together. But it got to a point, Demas abandoned Paul and went back again to the world. Mm-hmm. What am I trying to make you understand here? He saw the miracle. He saw what God was doing in the life of Paul. But he went back again to the world. Brethren, the reason why I'm saying this now is for many of us that are believing God for something, is for many of us that are believing God for miracle, for breakthrough, that in the time of life, as many of us that the Lord will settle, as many of us that the Lord will restore, that mark of destruction will not manifest in our life in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, eternal rock of ages, we magnify you, we adore you. We give you all the praise, we give you all the honor, we give you all the adoration. Father, we thank you, Lord, for making it possible for us to gather again before your presence. Father, we thank you, Lord, for the grace and strength that you have given upon us. Father, we thank you, Lord, for these 14 days praying and fasting. Father, your word says that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. Father, we have gathered again to hear your word and to pray our way through. Father, Lord God Almighty, as I open my mouth, O Lord, let the power of the Holy Ghost give me the utterances, O Lord, to say the right word according to your divine plan and purpose, not my will, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Father, Lord God Almighty, I surrender my body, soul, and spirit, O Lord, unto me. Father, use me again to the glory of your name alone and to the shame of the devil. And let the blessing rest upon us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, we are not ignorant of the devices of the devil according to your word in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 11. Father, we come against every spirit of distraction, spirit of wandering, buying and selling. We silence them, we cast them out of our midst in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, I pray children before you, every spirit of absent-mindedness, Father, I chase them out of their life. I chase them out of this gathering in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, do it again, you want to do it and take all the glory, take all the honor, take all the adoration, and let your name alone be glorified. Thank you, Father. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. All glory and honor be unto you. In Jesus' mighty name, I have prayed with thanksgiving.
Amen.
Brethren, our brief exhortation, should I call it, our prayer point this hour will be centered on the truth. On the truth. Building your word with truth. I am not preaching. We are going to be praying together. Praise Master Jesus. Building your word with truth. Brethren, the thing many of us are suffering today is because of the lies we sowed yesterday. I was discussing with my fellow brother in Christ, I said, I have come to understand one thing, that if you sow corn, it's corn that you reap. If you sow yam, those people who grew up in the village like me, if you sow yam, it's yam you will reap. You cannot plant corn and you come and harvest a melon from there, or you will plant cassava, or you come and harvest yam. Most of us today, we are the product of the lies we told yesterday. Most of us today are the product of the iniquity that was done yesterday. And right now, Satan is demanding for his own portion of it. Because you know why? The Bible makes us understand in the book of 1 John 1, in the book of 1 John chapter 3, verse 8. He said, he that committed sin is of the devil. For the devil sinned from the beginning. That for this purpose, the Son of God was manifested. That he might destroy the works of the devil. Thank God, by the divine direction of God, of the Holy Ghost, we all find ourselves in the cave of Adullam. So, brethren, what are we talking about? We have known the truth right now. That is why restitution is very, very important. All those words you acquire through false means, all those abominable things that you acquire through false means, every lie that you have ever told, like what the man of God said last time, this thing, things like this cannot be. It is very rare for many churches to say, they will say you are born again. All things are passed away. Yes, all things are passed away. But what of those lies that you told? All those things that you acquired in your old ways, will you not make amends for them? That is why this hour, our prayer is going to be centered, building your word with the truth. You have known the truth now. John 8:32 said, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Brethren, I want us to open our mouth again. Father, let your truth establish my foundation henceforth in the mighty name of Jesus. Brethren, the ticket to heaven is truth.
Amen.
The only way you and I will make it to heaven is the truth. We need to be an embodiment of truth. Jesus Christ was an embodiment of truth. He was the light, according to the book of John, chapter 1. We all know that the light is the truth, and the truth is the light. The Bible says in the book of John, chapter 1, verse 5, he said, the light shineth upon darkness, and darkness comprehended not. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So, brethren, what are we talking about now? The truth. Building your world with truth. I want you to open your mouth again and declare this one loud and clear. Father, let the light in your truth envelop my foundation, envelop my marriage, envelop my family in the mighty name of Jesus.
Father,
envelop
I want you to declare this one loud and clear again. Every satanic property in my foundation that have mortgaged my destiny, that have mortgaged my salvation, satanic property that is still in my belongings, that thing that you acquired when you were still in darkness, they are satanic property. They must go. Mm-hmm. I want you to open your mouth. Let the fire of the Holy Ghost burn them to ashes. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of
Jesus.
The Lord.
Hallelujah.
Brethren, the devil that many of us is waging war against is a legal expert. The devil is wickedly wicked and is badly bad. The devil knows very well, has to take an inventory of someone's life. The devil operates an intelligent satanic network that he used to manipulate people. Brethren, Apostle said one thing one day, don't hide and seek game that we played in the past. And right now, he's already telling on us now, but we don't know. I had a dream. What was that dream? That dream was as a reflection of those hide and seek game. Somebody said, taste by moonlight. All those dirty things that we do when the moon was shining. And we call them play. Brethren, I prayed yesterday. Immediately, I closed my eyes. It was like a flashback. I have not closed my eyes. It was not up to 30 minutes. It came into play. That play that we play, Satan magnified himself. He magnified himself and he wanted me to repeat that play in my dream. As I was about to do it, and I said, no. I said, no, not now. I don't just know. I said, no, later. As I just said that word, later, I just opened my eyes. I said, oh, Baba, you. This is how people are messed up in the dream. What am I trying to tell you, my beloved brethren? This was as a result of the seed we sowed. Satan saw it all. And he brings the same person, the same space, so that it will look as if it was that same play that you were playing. It will not look strange to you at all. He so magnified it, the same person, the same. We did those things together, that dirty play, long, long ago. He will bring that same face again. And before you know what is happening, it's either you are eating the food or you are messing up yourself in the dream. I want you to open your mouth and declare this one loud and clear. Every foundation that I've laid with darkness, I say disappear.
and let the light of God illuminate my foundation. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Father, in the name of Jesus, I command and I take away. Because I make that I command to be the light of God and appear in my foundation. Light of God, appear in my foundation. That in my life, in the name of Jesus.
Galatians chapter 3, verse 1. Apostle Paul was talking to the Galatians here. He said, oh, you foolish Galatians. Galatians, let's go there. Oh, foolish Galatians, who have bewitched you that you should not obey the truth, before which Jesus Christ has been evidently set forth, crucified among you. Brethren, if you go down in that scripture, you will discover these same Galatians, they were in the truth before. Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
He said, this only would I learn of you. Receive ye the truth by the works of the law or by hearing of the faith? So, brethren, these people have been bewitched. Who has bewitched them? Satan. So, in other words, these people, they hear the truth, but they are still walking in darkness. And as a result of that, their entire life has become foolish and darkened. I want you to open your mouth and declare this prayer point. Every foolishness that my wayward way has brought into my life, has brought into my foundation, I command you to disappear by fire. In the mighty name of Jesus. If you are a good reader of the Bible, you will understand that God has never kept us in darkness. He has always kept us to understand what we need to know. John chapter 8, verse 12. He said, then spake Jesus again unto them, saying, I am the light of the world. He that followeth me shall not walk in darkness. They shall have the light of life.
That's right.
When you walk according to the divine plan and purpose of God, you are walking in the light.
Amen.
And you will have the light of life.
Amen.
I want you to open your mouth again and declare this one out and clear. Say, that light of life
Envelope my life and my foundation. Envelope my family. In the name of Jesus. Let that light of life to envelope your life. To envelope your children. To envelope your marriage. In the name of Jesus. Light of life. Light of life. Envelope my life. Light of the world. Envelope my marriage. Envelope my foundation. Envelope my children. Brethren, if you turn your Bible again to the book of John, chapter 8, verse 44, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The Bible makes us to understand. It says, ye are of your father, the devil. The lust of your father, you will do. He was a murderer from the beginning. He abode not in the truth. Because he abode not in the truth. Amen.
Amen.
He said, ye are of your father the devil, and the lust of your father you will do. He was a murderer from the beginning, and abode not in the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own, for he is a liar and the father of it all. So, brethren, the question right now, or the assignment right now, check your life thoroughly. I need to check my life. Which foundation have you laid with lies? The Bible said, he's the father of it, for he's a liar and is the father of it. There is no golden lie. There is no sweet lie. There is no commercial lie. There is no business lie. There is no religious lie. Lie is a lie. The very moment you lie, you are obeying the devil. I am not the one that said it. Jesus Christ was talking talking here. He said, these people, the Jews, they are obeying the voice of their father, the devil, not his own voice. I pray as many of us that the Lord is speaking to in this mountain every day. We obey the voice of God, the eternity, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I want us to talk to God now to have mercy upon us again. Every foundation that we have laid with lies, even in the life of our children, many of us have sold and watered the life of our children with lies. Even our marriage, even the qualification, the academic qualification we acquired, even in that job that we are doing. Most people today, before you, or like in Nigeria, before you can get a job in the bank, you need to reduce your age. Before you can get that job, somebody who is already 40 will be bearing 30 or 25 years and is working. The Bible says there is a way that cement right unto a man. The end thereof is destruction. At this hour, brethren, I want us to open our mouth again and talk to the Lord. Father, search me and search me thoroughly. Search my foundation. Search my marriage. Search my this Christian faith that I proclaim right now. Search my foundation. Is there any lies that I've laid? Is there anyone that I've laid with lies? Have mercy upon me and deliver me. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Father, in the name of
Jesus. Your mother pray. And you pray for every satanic property. Before it's too late. Father, my God, thank you, blessed Redeemer. All glory and honor
hallelujah to you. Jesus, mighty name. Brethren, I want us to go back again to the works of the flesh. Most of us, we are swimming in it those days, and it's already telling us now. Most of us married in the altar of fornication.
You're right.
We do things before we got married. Yes. I pray the Lord will deliver every one of us this hour in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Satan is already accusing us now. Yes. The Bible makes us understand in the book of Hebrews chapter 13. I'm not making mistake. He said, the marriage is honorable when the bed is undefiled. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Let's turn our Bible to Hebrews chapter 13. Praise the Lord. God bless you.
Amen.
Hebrews chapter 13. I read from verse 4. Or you can read it.
Marriage is honorable in all, and the bed undefiled. But whoremongers and adulterers, God will judge. Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We are going to open our mouth. In any way, we have obeyed the voice of the devil. So people said, before I marry, I need to test. I need to test whether you can give me a tithe. And that time you conceive under the altar of fornication, you have mortgaged the destiny of that time. I pray the Lord will deliver such children in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I want you to open your mouth again and declare this one loud and clear. Every foundation that I have laid in my marriage in an altar of fornication, I say be destroyed. In the mighty name of Jesus, Brethren, if we can deal with the works of the flesh, heaven is sure for every one of us.
Sure.
The works, the Bible makes us understand in Galatians chapter 5, verse 17. It says, for the flesh lusteth against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh, and these are contrary one to the other, so that you cannot do the things that you will. You don't want to lie anymore, but you are still lying. Foundational problem. You don't want to commit adultery before, but you see yourself doing them. That is why we need to raise prayer point this hour and declare it loud and clear like this. Every works of the flesh, he has given you time now. You think he has relaxed. He has given you time now. God forbid somebody touch your sensitive button. They will see your real identity.
That's right.
He said, time will always tell. That is why we need to be very, very careful. David was a mighty man of warrior. David was fighting battle, destroying, dismantling. But on that day, when David was settled down in the palace, Mr. Flesh said, right now, David, take a walk. Take a walk. Go for sightseeing. Sightseeing. They call it sightseeing. Sightseeing. If I'm not right, correct me. Praise the Lord. David went for a stroll. And as he was strolling, Mr. Flesh said, look there. That is a woman naked, dressing there. Look. He looked one. He looked two. and he was consumed in lust. I want us to open our mouth and declare loud and clear. We all are here now. We are praying every day, fasting, doing all. Maybe on the day you will end the deliverance, you will finish this 14 days. Mr. Flesh will tell you, I am still here. I am not gone. I am here. I want you to open your mouth and declare this on every word of the flesh of that is still hiding, that is still hibernating. They are hiding now. That is still hiding in my foundation, waiting for a special day to manifest in order to destroy me. I say, die in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, that one of the flesh to die. Command it to die. The mighty name of Jesus. I command it to die. Every word of the flesh that is hiding in my foundation right now. That is hiding. Hiding in my foundation. I said die in the mighty name of Jesus. I said die by fire. I said die by fire. I said die by fire. Every word of my life. I want us to also raise this prayer point. In any way we have taken bribe or we have given bribe in order to get favor. Father, have mercy upon us. And deliver us, O Lord, for so ever anything we have acquired through that process. In the mighty name of Jesus. Every man is the architect of his destiny. If you are able to settle yourself, then your destiny is sure. Because you know why? The word of God is yea and amen.
Amen.
The Bible makes us understand if the ways of a man pleases God,
then
make it his enemy to be at peace with him.
Amen.
So that is the word of God for you. So brethren, a man said one word one day, and I deduced a very deep meaning from it. He said, if an enemy fired an arrow, or they came to oppress you, or they came to molest you, or they came to do anything to you in the dream, or attack you spiritually, he said the first question you need to ask is not you who launched the attack.
Mm-hmm.
He said, where did I miss it?
Exactly.
What was broken? Where did I break the egg? The Bible said, he that break the egg, that the serpent will bite. Mm-hmm. That word begin to ring in my brain. Most of us, we are saying, enemies die. Mm-hmm. We are our worst best enemy. Oh, Father, mm-hmm. deliver me from myself. In the mighty name of Jesus. Deliver me from myself, O Lord. Deliver me from myself. I don't even know myself at all. I don't even know what I do. Find myself doing those things that you detest. Those things that you hate. Those things that you dislike. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, deliver my wife. deliver my future from their self-love. Deliver me, Lord. Father, deliver me. Have mercy upon me. And deliver me. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Brethren, if you are in the spirit with me, you will agree with me that most of the things that we are reaping today is what we sow. Brethren, I just gave an example just now of what I experienced yesterday here. The thing were coming, it were not coming in the face of somebody I don't know. It was coming in the face of that same person that we were doing that hide and seek together. That is what we are talking about now. If an enemy launch an attack and that attack prosper, who launches is not what matters. Father, where did I miss it? Fall down on your knee and begin to ask for mercy. That is the truth that we need to do. So, brethren, what am I trying to say? Apostle read, would I call it a testimony yesterday? Or he read something to us yesterday. The woman said, I know the reason, oh, why I dreamt this dream. Oh, ah, we quarreled again. Yes, that was it. He did not blame the enemy. Say, hey, it's the enemy. Enemy have come, oh. Enemy have come, oh. Enemy is for my mother-in-law side. Or for my father-in-law side. No. The woman was able to identify and begin to plead for mercy. Brethren, if we can hide under the mercy of God and live holy and live pure, brethren, we will sleep like a baby and wake up like a baby. Amen. Our angel, our guardian angel will always be on guard. Amen. You go to bed with heavy heart. You go to bed with envy. We go to bed with jealousy, bitterness, hatred in our heart. Why will we not dream bad dreams? Why will we not see people chasing us in the dream? So, brethren, we are going to pray that the Lord should deliver us in any way. We have created a legal foundation for the devil to manipulate, oppress, depress, and control our life in the mighty name of Jesus. Ask for mercy and thank the Lord to deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus. My God, my Redeemer, my Savior. O King, so Lord, omnipotent God, I surrender my body, my spirit, unto you. Father, Lord, Almighty, I bring my wife, my children before you. Every wrong foundation that we have created, the Lord, that is making the devil to oppress us, to depress us, to manipulate us, and to control our lives now. Father, we ask for your mercy. In the mighty name of Jesus, we ask for your mercy. Deliver us, O Lord. Deliver us, O Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, deliver, 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 deliver my wife, deliver my children. In the mighty name of Jesus, deliver us, O Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, and let your name alone be glorified forever. Lord, you are God. Glory and honor be unto you. So, brethren, what are we talking about? Building your word with truth. Building your word with truth. Brethren, you don't need the man of God to tell you some certain things again. The word of God settles it all. The Bible makes us to understand. When Joshua was about to take the mantle of leadership, Joshua chapter 1, verse 8, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God has never kept us in darkness. He has always made us to know what we need to know. When Joshua was about to take the mantle of leadership, God called Joshua. It's not that Joshua did not see what he was doing in the life of Moses. But right now, he wants to commission him. Joshua, it is now your turn to lead these people to that promised land that I promised your forefathers. And he gave Joshua a specific directive. Let's read it. If you are there, Joshua chapter 1, I want you to read from, let's take it from verse 6. If you are there, read Joshua chapter 1. From verse 6.
Be strong. Joshua chapter 1, verse 6 to 8.
be strong and of a good courage. For unto these people shall that divide for inheritance the land, which I swear unto their father to give them. 7. Only be thou strong and very courageous, that thou mayest observe to do according to all the law, which Moses my servant commanded thee. Turn not from it to the right hand or to the left, that thou mayest prosper, go whither thou goest. Verse 8. This book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is within, that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success.
Amen. 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 Man of God. Brethren, is this word ambiguous?
No.
At all.
Is it crystal clear? If you know it's crystal clear, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Brethren, you don't need an interpreter to make you understand this message again. If you want to be prosperous, if you want to have a good success in this life, in the life that we are living now, in this Christian race, what do you need to do? This book of the law shall not depart out of the mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou may observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make the way prosperous, and thou shalt have a good success. Brethren, like I will always say when I go in evangelism, I will tell the Germans, I said, if there is no law that is governing you people, the way you people are dressing half naked, you will not get right.
Mm-hmm.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And the way you people are living, the streets would have been, there would have been what we call anarchy. There would have been a high level of abuse. That is how it is. The reason we are heaven is sure for us is because of this book of the law, this book of truth that we have in our hand. The Bible said, if you can meditate on it day and night, not only when you come to a gathering like this in the church, not only when they said, let's come and pray. No, as you study the word of God, you begin to meditate on it. You begin to confess it. You begin to speak it. I don't need to be embarrassed by spirit wife. I don't need to be embarrassed by spirit husband. Father, if I have created a legal grant, have mercy upon me. Deliver me. You don't need somebody that will come and pray a bulldozing prayer upon your head, who you don't know the foundation of that person. Some people will collect prayer here. They will go to Martin B, collect prayer. They will go to the Mount of Marie, collect prayer. They will mix all together. And by the time you begin to push them, overdose, then they will not say enemy has started. Whereas you are yourself best enemy. Say, my Father, my God, grant me the grace and strength to obey your word and dwell in your truth. In the mighty name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray that prayer for yourself. Lord, my God, I am the Lord. Brethren, most of us today, the reason why we are in this mountain today is because I call it divine problem. Number one, I always like to use myself. My beloved sister, if not what she saw, if not what she went through, if not where God pulled her from, you cannot tell her, come and dress like this. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
What am I trying to say in an essence?
We call such a problem that brought you out from the mouth of the devil and set you on the right path to heaven. What do you call such a problem?
Divine problem.
Divine problem.
Shout
hallelujah.
Okay, I used myself as an example again. If I have gotten my document in the altar of adultery, I will, if you tell me about this one, though I love to serve God, but I will still be practicing that bread and butter Christianity. God understand, we are saved by grace. Yes, we are saved by grace. He said, must you continue to remain in sin that grace might abound? The Bible said, God forbid.
God forbid.
I want you to open your mouth and declare this one loud and clear. I will not disgrace the grace of God upon my life in the mighty name of Jesus.
Father, in the name of Jesus, I will not disgrace the grace of God upon my life in the mighty name of Jesus. I will never disgrace the grace of God upon my life.
We pray. I want us again to turn our problem to further explain what I've said just now. In the book of Exodus chapter 13 verse 18, he said, but God led the people about through the way of the wilderness and of the Red Sea. And the children of Israel went up, harnessed out of the land of Egypt. And Moses took the bone with him, for he had straightly sworn that the children of Israel, saying, God will surely visit you, and you shall carry up my bone. Sorry, I take it again. Moses took the bones of Joseph with him, for he had straightly sworn that the children of Israel, saying, God will surely visit you, and you shall carry up my bones away hence with thee. Okay, that is not what I really want. Okay, verse 17. What I'm looking for is really in verse 17. Verse 17. He said, and it came to pass when Pharaoh had let the people go, that God led them not through the ways of the land of the Philistines. I'm reading Exodus chapter 13, verse 17. God led them not through the ways of the land of the Philistines, although that was near. For God said, lest peradventure the people repent when they see war and they return to Egypt. I don't know the prayer that you have been praying now. Father, bless me with the fruit of the womb. Father, let this thing stop. Look at you now. By the time you receive it now, if they call you for prayer, you say, does not matter. You will not remember your bed. You will not know how important your bed are. But right now, because of that spirit husband that is embarrassing you in the dream each time you close your eye, if they say pray, you answer the prayer. You are the one that will complete it. I pray our problem will not take us away from the presence of God in Jesus' name. I want us to open our mouth again and declare this one loud and clear. Every stubborn situation in our life that is resisting at the power of God will not take me away from the presence of God in the mighty name of Jesus. Open your mouth.
Allah,
Brethren, many of us have become a warrior. Why? Because many of us have become what? A warrior. Because of the problem we are going through.
Mm-hmm.
We now know how to read our Bible. We now know how to do night vigil for ourselves. Praise Master Jesus. So, brethren, you can see what happened here. He said, least by peradventure, they repent when they see war. In other words, there was a land that was very close to that they will not encounter the Red Sea at all.
Mm-hmm.
But upon all what God did, what did they still do? They rebelled and they were being wasted under the pillar of cloud of God's protection. I pray the Lord will help every one of us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
If you go to verse 21, people don't understand when the reason why I raised that prayer point. That prayer point is being raised for many of us that are believing God for something. We need to be fervent. This is the time for you to be strong. It's for you to be spiritually built up. That is why maybe God is still keeping it for a while. So that your miracle, my miracle, will not take us away from the presence of God in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Brethren, if you go to verse 21 of that say, Exodus 13, he said, the Lord went before them by day in a pillar of cloud to lead them in the way by the night and by night in a pillar of fire to give them light to go by day and night. Verse 22, he took not away the pillar of cloud by day, nor the pillar of fire by night from before the people. So can anything be as secure as this? He gave them a divine assurance. So in other words, it was that pillar of fire, nor the pillar of cloud, that would have led them to the promised land with no problem, with no hassles or obstacles on the way. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Pray, as many of us have, the Lord has brought to his vineyard, we all will design the handwriting on the wall, and we all will be able to follow suit and walk according to the word of God in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It was divine problem that took Joseph to palace. It was divine problem that took Joseph to palace. If Potiphar has not embarrassed, if Potiphar's wife has not embarrassed Joseph in that comfort zone, Joseph would have found himself in the prison yard that connected him to the butler. The butler that connected him to Pharaoh that said, I knew a man that interpreted the dream. Said, Father, bring a problem in my way that will draw me closer to you in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord help us, bless his word in our heart in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I know some people will not pray that prayer for just and say, what kind of prayer this man is praying? I pray the Lord will grant you the spirit of understanding in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Father, in the name of Jesus, I give you thanks, I give you praise, I give you honor. Father, I thank you again for your grace and mercy that you have given honor to us to pray our way through. Father, as many of us, O Lord, that are praying in genuineness, in the sincerity of our heart this hour, Father, deliver us, O Lord, and make our foundation to be pure and established in your truth and your truth alone, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now, Lord God Almighty, as many of us, O Lord, that you have delivered, we will not entangle ourselves again. In Jesus' mighty name, I have prayed with thanksgiving. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Over to you, man of God. I'm sorry for taking
your
time.
No, bro, the Lord have done so great thing for us today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So when you talk about that prayer, just that people don't understand. I want somebody to quickly go to 1 Corinthians chapter 2, 7 and 8. 1 Corinthians 2, 7 and 8.
1 Corinthians 2, 7 and 8. I read.
Yes, sir.
Okay. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 7 and 8.
Yes,
sir.
Yes. Yes, read.
Okay. 3.
2, 7 and 8. 7 and 8.
Praise,
7.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But we impart a secret and hidden wisdom of God, which God decreed before the ages for our glory. None of the rulers of this age understood this, for if they had, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. I read in King James Version.
But we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery, even the hidden wisdom which God ordained before the world unto our glory. Verse 8. Which none of the princes of this world knew. For had they known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. Amen.
Amen. What am I trying to say? If that problem know that through him or her, I use feminine now, masculine now as that problem, that you will be on this mountain today, that problem would have run away from you.
Mm-hmm.
The Bible, if the princes and princes of the world knew that killing Christ, that problem they gave to Christ, we make him to be the Lord of all Lord and King of all kings. They would have left him on earth to be giving bread and turning fish to these small people here. But they never knew that nailing him to the cross, flogging him, dealing with him, we make him to be the King of all kings and the King of glory. I don't know what you are going through. The power behind my thing, I've afflicted this man. Hey, I've hindered him. Hey, I did not give him document. He never knew. He just that document he took from me for now. He took you away from sudden death. Yeah, I knew that the Lord is some problem are favor in these guts.
That's right.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So foolish that you see all problems as if they are life-taking. No. Some problems are there to checkmate you. Some problems are there to draw you close to God. Some problem comes to put you in a place so you will not go out that day. But then you may want to go out, you hit your leg or something, blood will come out and say, hey, any devil that did this, hey. That little blood that came out, maybe your head would have go out when you go out.
No.
And that kind of little blood drop on the ground that you are shouting, hey, it was your angel that pushed you to that thing to hit your leg there. To delay you. If you have entered road without speed, either one of your child or you would have gone. That's why it's not up and say, I bind you, Satan, I bind you, Satan. No. Some blessing in disguise. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So that problem that will make us to fly into heaven may come our way in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You will call it problem, but God will not call it problem. He called it a channel.
Amen.
To Joseph, hey, this was not my dream. Oh, hey, this was not my dream. prison wasn't my dream. He never knew that problem was his channel to go to where the Lord is leading him to. So be courageous, be strong, and know that the Lord never sleep nor slumber. You get there.
Amen.
But
amen.
You get there.
Amen.
And at that time, all those household enemy, all those power, they say, hey, I hold her bound. They don't know they are prolonging your destiny for you, prolonging your life for you.
Amen.
And when the Lord shall come up, it will go down. Who would have known? Who would have known Lazarus? Who knew if Lazarus and Joseph were connected? If not for that 4 days. Today now, the whole world is hearing of him. The Lord will advertise you because of that problem that come your way in the name of Jesus Christ. Open your mouth and say, Father, thank you. Thank you for bringing me. I'm glad I know you. I'm glad I'm close to you. I'm glad I know you. In the name of Jesus Christ. If not for that thing, by now, thank you, Jesus. 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 But I beg you, don't go out in your heart to look for a problem. Don't try it. And I pray the Lord every so busy body that will make God to fall into problem. May it not come our way in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Not all problem. There is one that is divine problem, as my brother called it, divine problem that the Lord Himself manufactured to humiliate the devil in your life. But the one you sin, you fornicate, not get HIV, that one is not the problem. Or you went to go sleep with another man's wife, they pour hot oil on you there. That one is not the right problem. You are the one that draw down to yourself. You will get it to yourself, in yourself, at yourself, for yourself. Hallelujah. Brethren, by the grace of God, we'll be coming again by 4. No, let's come again once again. By 5 p.m. Okay? So you can rest for a long time. We are coming again by 5 p.m. We come for Holy Communion and so that you can have a rest. Amen. Go now, digest what you have heard in this prayer point. If possible, go to it again and listen to it again and do more research of yourself. We are the most time we are the problem we are having. Without sin, we cannot sink. It's sin that sink men. And I pray the grace to run from sin, we receive it today in Jesus' name. It is offering time. Amen.